Hi everyone, in this video I'll be showing you how to check if a substring is present in a string in Python. So I'll be showing you two ways how you can solve this. One is by using an inbuilt function and the second way is by using a if statement. So you can choose whichever the way that suits you. So let's get started. So first we'll be inputting two strings. One is going to be the main string and another one is going to be the substring. So let main string be my the main whole string equal to input, enter string, and let me just now copy this and paste it, and let my substring be the second input. So first thing, the if condition way, so it's so simple, it's just a if else block, that's it. So if substring in main string, that's it, this is the code. Yeah. So if our substring is in main string, we will just print yes, it is present, and we'll be having a else block saying print no, it's not present inside it. You can just have not present, something like that. Yeah, that's it. But the only disadvantage by this method is that we won't be able to detect the index number or the point at which our substring is occurring. So that can be done by using the second method that I will show in a while. So let me just now run this. So I need to enter a string. I will go with hello world. So substring. So for substring, I will go with WO. Okay. So we need to get yes. So you can see I'm getting yes. So let me just run it again. Same thing. Hello world. This time I will go with O. Okay. Maybe. Yeah. So it's not present. So this is it, guys. And this is the first method, and the second method that I'm going to show is by using a find inbuilt function. So let me just have this exact same thing. All right, we need this. Okay, we need a if condition. So let's just have that. So we'll be using the find inbuilt function. Okay, so let me just now comment this. Let me just cut this at first. Yeah. So for this, what we will do is, let me just show you how find inbuilt function works. I'll just print. We need to use the main string variable name, okay, which is main string in our case. So I'm going to just pass this variable name dot find function, and within the find function we need to pass our substring. Okay, so we need to pass our substring, that's it. Saving it now, running it. So I will go with exact same hello world, and this time I will go with ll. So this time we need to get 0. The indexing basically starts from 0. It is not from 1. So 0, 1, 2. This is where this particular LL starts. So we need to get 0, 1, 2. 2 in the output. So here you can see, right? It basically returns us the starting index of our substring. And what if I enter a substring that is not present inside our main string itself? So just go with hello. And if I enter OO, so we'll be getting minus 1. So we'll be just using this particular concept to print our substring is present in our main string or not. So if that particular find function returns minus 1, it means that that particular substring is not present inside our main string. And if it returns any other number apart from minus 1, it means that the substring is present in the main string. I hope that made sense. So now let's just convert this to a if statement. I'll just paste it. Okay, that's gone. So I'll just have a if statement. If exact same thing, I'll just now copy this thing, put it here. What did I say? If it's equal to minus 1, which means that print not present, correct? Yeah. And next we will just be having a else condition. It's going to be print, we'll just put it as yes, present in index. So maybe just we can just do this. Okay, we can just, rather than repeating it, we can just have a variable known as index, and we can just put this, and we can just use this index here. Yeah, that's much better. So this print statement is optional. You can just have it absolutely your choice. So this is the code basically, guys. Yeah, just have it in a variable and use this index everywhere rather than repeating the operation again and again. So if I run it now, I'll be going with exact same hello. I'll go with LO this time. And this time, see, I'm getting yes present in 3. So yeah, that's because of this print statement, the first 3 that we got. So this is working perfectly fine. And let me just final check with the invalid substring. Yeah, I'm getting not present. So that's it, guys. Hope you would have found this video useful. Do check the playlist of my channel. I've done many other Python programming tutorials, as well as C, Java, Node.js, C++, MySQL, MongoDB, CRUD operations using Node.js and Spring Boot. So check the other videos of my channel. Subscribe me. Thanks for watching.